change. Congresswoman Kristi Noem played a role in writing the reform law. News Center 1's Eric Green spoke with her about some of the changes you'll notice.
Changing the tax code, it was about fixing the unfairness of it.
Congresswoman Kristi Noem is a member of the House Commerce Committee that helped craft the tax reform bill. While tax advantages given to businesses have garnered much of the attention, Noem says she's proud of what individuals and families will gain.
You know, half of the American population, almost half of them, don't have $400 in a savings account. That means if they have an emergency, they have no backup plan. And so our goal was to give them some extra money in their pocket.
According to Noem, the average South Dakota family brings in $54,000 a year, usually with two incomes.
Yeah, and that's not very much money. For them, they used to pay about $830 in taxes. Now they're going to get a $780 refund. So for that family, that's life-changing. And that's not counting the increase in wages that we're starting to see, the bonuses from employers. You know, that's the real life evidence that this tax reform was needed.
While the tax reform bill was being hammered out in Washington, there were reports that some people would actually see their taxes go up. Noem says it's possible, but not in the way people would think.
But what we're seeing is that if anybody's taxes went up, it's those people that were taking advantage of all kinds of loopholes and exemptions that were in place. You know, there was the state and local tax deduction that we dealt with.
Noem cites people who live in high tax states, such as California and New York, who could use their location to their benefit on their federal return. No longer.
A lot of really low tax states like South Dakota were subsidizing states like Illinois, California, because we kept our state taxes low and then paid our federal income taxes. They increased their state taxes to benefit their state budget. But then those individuals deducted it off their federal taxes, and that was less money coming into the federal government. So we capped that at $10,000 per person, and that's going to make a big difference in leveling that playing field.